Hi everyone, this is Sunita. I'm a senior product manager at Muvi.com. Today in this video, we are going to talk about the different methods provided in Muvi platform to monetize various contents in your store, be it audio, video, or physical. Whether you choose to monetize your content with advertising, subscription, transactional, or all of it together, Muvi provides it all. Now let's take a look at how do you set all that up in using Muvi's content management system. After you are done setting up your content and selecting a template for your website, you can go to our monetization module here. First of all, you need to set up a payment gateway through which you want to receive all your transactions. Just to inform, the gateway will be directly linked to your bank account and Muvi does not take any percentage from your transactions. All you have to pay Muvi is your monthly fee. Now, coming back to the gateway, we provide 12 plus payment gateways off the shelf, and you can integrate any outfit in your platform provided you have the correct gateway credentials. Now, let's say you want to integrate Stripe. If you click on Stripe, you see this secret key and public key, and you can integrate the payment gateway. If you do not see your desired payment gateway listed, you can always raise a support ticket over here, and we will integrate the gateway for you for a one-time fee. By default, your store has a test gateway activated, which facilitates you to check and test the various features we offer. Now from monetization, you can go to settings. And here you can select the various monetization models we have to offer. Like you can select subscription, pay-per-view, advertising. You can offer your contents for free. You can set up pre-order. You can package your contents together using a pay-per-view bundle. We also have coupons and vouchers options in our monetization model. We also have a career billing option. Career billing is through which your users can pay any amount using their mobile phone balance. If we enable career billing, we will see the option over here. And if you go inside career billing, you will see all the career billing currently we are supporting. So as you can see, currently we only support M-Pesa as our career billing service provider. You can, like gateways, you can always raise a support ticket to integrate career billing service provider also, and we will do that for you for a one-time fee. Now let's go back to the module again. And change our gateway. Okay, now you can also, we also provide various restrictions how the user accesses the website. Like you can, you need not want your user to log in or register to see your content. So you can select this option and this will restrict, this will not ask the users to register when they come to view the website. If you have free contents, then you can keep a track of your users by selecting this option, login required for free content. If anyone clicks on any content, then the system will ask for login or registration details. We also provide option for geo-blocking. Geo-blocking as in you can either entirely geo-block, you can geo-block your entire website for a particular geographical area, or you can geo-block specific contents. If I select the entire website, I can select the default option is it's available in all the countries. You can select in which all countries you do not want your content to be available. Similarly, if you select geo-block specific contents, you can select a category. You can give any category name, let's say test category. And you just want your content to be available in India only. We will update. You can go to manage content, content library. And here for the particular content, you can set up a geo block. So here you will see the category and you can select it. Now let's take a look at the particular monetization models. Let's select subscription, pay-per-view, free content, pre-order, pay-per-view bundles, coupons, vouchers, etc. When you select all the options, you see all of them defined under the main monetization module. You can go to subscription and you can define a plan for your end users. Like as you can see, I have defined a test plan. The plan name is A, the duration is 1 month, and the subscription fee I want to charge is $20. Like if you click on add, you will see all the details and you can fill up all the details as required. You can offer your users a free trial. We have options of free trial period like 1 day. One day, 7 day, 14 day, 1 month, etc. You can define your subscription plan for specific contents. You can add any content and create a group, and it will be your limited content subscription plan. So users taking this subscription plan will only have access to the specific contents. Now let's take a look at pay-per-view. In pay-per-view, you can define the different pay-per-view categories. You can define the pay-per-view for single part content, for multi-part content, or you can add a category. And you can define subscriber price, non-subscriber price. You can define various various currencies. You can set it up in different currencies. And under pay-per-view, we also have another option of defining particular rule. Like you can restrict the number of views, you can restrict the content by access period, watch period. You can define a particular rule over here. And as you saw, you can select that rule when defining your PPV category. And the restriction will be applicable to that content. Similarly, you can define pay-per-view bundles. When combining different contents together, you can offer it as a bundle. You can use it, you can use to combine a video, a audio, and a related physical product for the same package. And you can also define pre-order over here. You can add a category. You can add the currency, the subscriber, non-subscriber price. And till when you want your pre-order thing to be activated, and when your content is live, the users will receive a notification and they can watch the content if they have paid in advance for the content. We also have options for vouchers. You can define a one-time voucher or a multi-use voucher. Like the voucher code be applicable for multiple use. When you define one-time voucher, the voucher code will be applicable only for once use. You can define the valid range. Like pay-per-view model, you can select you can define the access period, watch period while defining vouchers. Like here, and you can select the particular rule for the particular content when you're defining the content. We provide the voucher option for all content or specific content. Now let's go to coupons. Coupons also the same thing. Coupons can be used with our subscription plan. Coupons can be used with a PPV plan. You can use, you can give coupons to your users for any kind of use. Similarly, here you can define a cash or a percentage to be cut from the actual amount. You can define the range, you can define the contents. You can define for which monetization model you want to use the coupon, PPV or subscription, etc. Now, let's go to free contents. So in free contents, you can just define the content which you want your user to watch freely. And when they click on the particular content, they will not be asked for payment or anything, and the content will play directly. We also have invoice options where you can customize the invoice you want to set your users. You can define the logo dimension. You can define the invoice logo. And we will use these details while we send the invoice to your end user. So I guess this is it from the monetization module, and we will be back with more details on different modules soon. Thank you so much.